finding from Golden Guy. Fast draw bonding along just on the outside of him. A steer is running forth, a couple of lengths back to another grey in Fairy Law. Cash in on the outside of him. Jim Doolan comes next. Then Macquarie, Nash Amore, Stormy Weather making ground. Modicum is next, and Habara by back at the rear. The first of the two fences on top of the hill, and over goes a Mayu ahead of Golden Guy. Fast draw didn't jump that one as cleanly as he might have done. A steer, on the other hand, took it beautifully. They're at the second on top of the hill, and over they go. The leader's over safely. They have all cleared it with Hamara by jumping very slowly back at the rear of the field. Down the hill they cover. Mayu is the leader. Fast draw now moving into second position on the outside of Golden Guy and the snare. They're out by about 4 to 5 lengths. Cashin and Fairy Law together next. Behind them, Stormy Weather. The gap back to Jim Doolan, Modicum, Macquarie, Nashimore, and Hammurabi. And over the fence they come at the foot of the hill. And they've cleared it and come over to the crossing. They've got another live fence ahead of them. Then the stand double. And after that, another circuit of the track. And Fast Draw, the chestnut just leading there from Omehu and Golden Guy. In behind them, Astaire, Fairy Law, Cashin. They're at the fence. Jim Doolan, Stormy Weather, jump with the Cashin. They're followed by Modicum, didn't manage it too well. Nash Amore, Macquarie, and a long gap back to Hammurabi. They come to the stand double, and the pacemaker is still going to be Fast Draw.
20 cents a go, it come over. Any more plans now, there's a 10 or 20 cents a shot. Yeah, 2 bob or 10 cents a go, it come over.
Thank you. And you came from Yugoslavia to New Zealand, and when was that?
1925, 8th of January, 3 o'clock.
You've been in New Zealand ever since. How do you like it here?
Best country in the world. I've been here ever since.
Thank you very much. Well, here we are, and you describe this area as what, the headlands, or?
The headlands of the Littleton Harbor.
And this is Marion and Trevor Scott, and their two daughters and son. Trevor, how do you describe your occupation to us?
As a lighthouse keeper, attending the light, and all maintenance on the station, keeping it up to standard.
Now, you're away from civilization a bit, so to speak, so I suppose, Marion, you don't have much to do.
Oh, no, I've got three children to teach, correspondence lessons.
I suppose you do a little housekeeping, too?
Oh, yes, that's right. We've got rather a large house to keep clean.
The children don't go to public school, then? You do all the teaching here?
Yes, that's right.
How do you folks like this? Trevor, you've been in this for quite some time.
Yes, 14 years now, and we like it, the fresh air, away from all the smog and the city rush and bustle.
I was going to ask you, how long does one of those lights burn?
The bulbs themselves, we keep them going for 1,000 hours, and then we throw them away.
Well, we certainly appreciate your talking to the picture log cameras. We're going to talk to the boys and girls here after a while, but for right now, we thank all five of you for appearing on picture log cameras.
You've been welcome.
Thank you for the tea.
Oh, you're welcome.
Captain, you learned your flying, your basic flying where?
Up in the Wellington Aero Club in the North Island.
And how long have you been flying here at Mount Cook?
Been here about 1 year, sir, 1 year.
And tell me now, we're going up there on wheels and skis. Is there anything different about the takeoff and landings on skis?
Oh, a lot different, yes. It's a lot different from taking off on the runway you see out here. The whole technique is different.
Do you have to have more speed, or what is it?
You have to have more speed and more power and greater judgment.
And these planes are inspected regularly?
Every 50 hours, they are given a thorough overhaul.
Well, if we're safe, let's go, huh? You're going to take us out into Milford Sound and show us a little bit about how you fish.
This is true, yes. See.
What will we see?
Well, you'll see what we do every day working. Like we throw the pot over the side and go around, come back and pick it up.
And if you...
Just to give you an idea.
If you picked it up, about how many pounds of lobster would you hope to find in a good pot?
Well, you could get up to 2 bags with about 80 pounds in a pot.
And about how much do you catch? What has your largest catch been?
The largest has been 14 ton for the day.
14 ton. And you sell that for how much money?
$3.50 a pound.
$3.50 a pound?
That's true. See.
And how many tons?
14.
14 tons. Do you need a partner?
Come along.